Right, Aki Kareem here for BBTV. I'm with heavyweight prospect Stan Bertens. Stan, thanks for joining me, mate. Are you joining us from the Netherlands at the minute?
Yeah, I'm at home. We are just back from a vacation, and training has started again, so I'm preparing for my next fight.
Nice, nice. Well, for people who, I mean, you have been on the channel a couple of times, but for people who haven't seen you yet, you're a heavyweight prospect. You're from the Netherlands. You compete for your national team. You've also been over in England doing some valuable sparring with people like Dave Allen, like Tyson Fury, with Steve Egan. So just tell us a little bit. You told me you were going to be in England next week, maybe. Tell us about this.
Yeah, well, like you said, training has started again. We came back from the European Games at the start of July. And we're going to Sheffield to the GB team next week. And then our training starts again, our first camp again.
Nice, nice. So that's going to be great experience. It's going to be a lot of competitive training. Are you going to be planning some more good sparring whilst you're over here?
Well, we're sparring all week at the GB Center, so of course Delicious will be there. He's going to the Olympics. He qualified at the European Games. Also, America and France will be there, so I'm expecting some good heavyweights there.
Oh yeah, you're gonna have some good practice. Did you manage to spar with Delicious? Have you sparred with him
I've
before?
sparred with him before. In Italy, I sparred with him, and at the GB Center. Yeah.
Yeah, I was the ring announcer at the Commonwealth Games, so I got to see his win right up and close, and I was very impressed. How did you find the sparring with Delicious?
It's okay. He is it's not like he has he's not like a really awkward fighter. So he's quite a standard fighter, but he has the basics very good. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I know exactly what you mean. Someone like a bit like Anthony Joshua, very good
Yeah,
orthodox type of boxer. Yeah.
that's my feeling with that I get with him.
Yeah. I think he might be. He was commentating on a show the other day. I think he may. I don't know if this is true, but so he's planning on going to the Olympics and then after that, potentially turning over as a professional. Is that
Yeah,
what you're planning on
I
doing as
understand
well?
that. What did you say?
I said, is that what you're planning as well? Is it a similar sort of path, Olympics perhaps, and then turning professional?
Yeah, 100%. Next February or and March we have the last qualifiers. If I qualify, I go to Olympics and I turn pro. If I not qualify, it's always possible, then I turn pro straight away.
Yeah. For those people watching, how old are you? Because I know you're very young.
I just turned 23 yesterday.
Oh, happy birthday, mate.
Thank you, thank you.
22, you're 6'7", is it?
Yeah, 6'6", 6'7". Yeah.
Yeah. And how much do you weigh?
122 kilos.
Oh man, do you know in stones? Do you know what that is in
I
stones?
know, I have no idea. I think it's
Right, let me
around
Google this because I want
18
to
or
give everything.
19 stone or something.
So tell me again, bro, and I'll work it out right now.
122 kilos.
122 kilograms. I should know this, but in stone, right? In stone. You are 19 stone, 2 pounds. So big lad, all the right dimensions for the heavyweight game. And you need to be looking out for Stan. Now, I know you compete for your national team. You're very proud of that. But you've also been over in England. Is there any plans to have a more of a frequent base here in England?
Yeah, well, I'm very happy with Steve. He's a great coach, and he's helping me everywhere it's possible. And well, I think if I turn pro, I need to go and look at England because pro boxing here in the Netherlands, I don't see a future. It's just too hard, and then we have only two options: the UK or going to the United States. But UK is a better option, I think.
Yeah, we'd love to see you here. Just out of interest, who else, is there anybody else? Are there any other names before I talk to you about the basis of this video, in a sense? Are there any other names that you've sparred in the heavyweight division that we might know of?
Here in the Netherlands, we have a lot of kickboxers, of course.
Right.
So I spar with a lot of kickboxers. Rico Verhoeven is now like 10, 12 years the heavyweight champion of kickboxing at Glory. He's fighting on November 4th again. So Also, we are preparing now there a lot. And I think I at this point I need to do with the resources we have. You know, it's very difficult to spar because there are not a lot of heavyweights here in the Netherlands. There are, but then you need to look at the kickboxers.
Yeah. Well, yeah, I know Rico. He comes over here to spar with Huey Fury. So yeah, yeah, a few times. Great. Well, let me bring in then the sort of, 'cause this weekend, sorry, next weekend, I will talk to you about this weekend's fight in a second, but next weekend, Dave Allen fights Fraser Clark. And the reason I want to speak to you is because you've sparred Dave Allen. Now, it was at the beginning of his comeback, so it probably he was just getting back into sparring. But it was still a great spar to watch and very interesting. What did you make of sparring with Dave and that experience?
Of course, it's an honor to spar with Dave because Dave is very well known. It's definitely in the UK. He has a lot of good pro experience, and it's good to measure because at that time I sparred with Dave. I didn't have a lot of spar. I didn't not have a lot of sparring sessions with pros, so I could measure myself, to the pro level. It's very I know where I'm at.
Yeah. Now, like I say, it was the beginning of Dave's comeback. He's now significantly he's months into his comeback, but still, it was an interesting experience for you. Tell us what you thought Dave did well that you noticed as a pro.
Well, Dave's that's the thing with Dave. I think he's a diesel. So he doesn't have the highest pace there is, but he keeps coming. So I think if Frazier doesn't have his condition right, Dave is going to run right to him with his condition.
Have you done anything with Fraser? Because you mentioned the GB team there. Obviously, Fraser was part of the GB team for years. Probably he's obviously 10 years older than you, but did you
Yeah.
ever cross paths?
No, never. I saw he fought some guys I also fought, but no, I never met him.
Going back to the spar with Dave, he's quite one thing I noticed because I watched that spar. It was really great to watch to be a ringside spectator that at that spar. He had a lot of praise for you afterwards. But one thing I noticed that Dave's quite a sneaky fighter. He quite he work you know, he's almost like he lulls you into a false
The
sense of
rising.
yeah. Tell me about that.
I think Fraser needs to look out for the overright hand because Davis has a very good fight IQ, I think, and he just sets you up for the right hand. So if you're not too fast on the feet, he gets you in the corner, he's gonna try and land it overhand right.
Yeah, it's a dangerous shot. And what about Fraser? What do you see his strengths being?
Well, I think Fraser is yeah, they call it amateur, but I call it Olympic record. It's very good. He has, of course, some gold medals, bronze at the Olympics. So his Olympic record is perfect. In the pros, I don't know yet because he hasn't really fought like good opposition. And I think Dave is a good step up for him to get his competition level up.
How do you see the fight going? I know you're keen to sort of maybe even come and watch it, but how do you see that fight going?
Because I am in the UK next week. I fly there on the September 1st, and September 2nd is the fight. And Sheffield to Manchester isn't that bad, of course. So I'm really want to come and watch the fight, and I think Dave will win by knockout, I think, in around 6 or 7.
Okay, that's an interesting prediction. It's it goes slightly against the I think the bookies have Fraser slightly ahead as a favorite. What makes you feel obviously us being based in Manchester, we spoke to a lot of people who think Dave will win. In Derby, people say that Fraser will win. Why do you think Dave is going to win by knockout?
Well, Dave has fought in the pros, of course, some big names. He has more pro experience. I think he's a little bit more used to to make some more rounds in a fight. I think his condition, if he trained properly, I think what I just said, like the diesel, it just keeps going. I think he will overwhelm Frazier, and I think he will find that overhand right eventually. I think Frazier will not have an answer for it.
Okay, fair enough. You also sparred as well. I think it might have even been the week after or the day after. I can't even remember. You sparred Tyson Fury on that same trip, didn't you?
Yeah, same week. Yeah.
Week, yeah. He's just released a series on Netflix, At Home with the Furies. I don't know if you have you seen any of it yet.
Yeah, I just finished it yesterday evening.
What did you think of it?
I love it. I love the show.
Maybe we'll have At Home with the Burtons one day. You never know.
Maybe, never know. You know, it just gives a look in his life because, of course, he shares a lot on social media, but also you see in the show sometimes he just pulls himself away from everybody, and that's the part that you normally don't see on his social media, of course.
Yeah. I mean, you, one of the things that comes across is his up and down personality. Did you sparred with him? I don't know how long this, how many rounds you sparred with him, but did you get a sense of that? Was it up and down in the sparring, or was he very consistent? Was it almost like he switches into gear when sparring time?
No, he keeps the pace up very high. We did a few rounds of shadow boxing, a few rounds of backs, a few rounds of sparring, and yeah, he just uses his body so damn well. He uses his length, he uses his weight, he puts it on you, and yeah, I don't know, I never sparred somebody like that.
What when you say you never sparred anybody like that, what was the main thing? Was it the IQ? Was it the fact that he's just so big and he uses that size to a great advantage? Was it the experience? What do you think it was?
I think all of the above because he uses the fight IQ because he knows he has that body and he uses it well, and of course he got the experience. So yeah, he got the experience how to use that body, and that's just all in all, yeah, really great fighter.
When I spoke to you at the amateur boxing show, you said you felt Tyson beats Alexander Usyk. You say he's just too big. So I won't go over old ground, but Alexander Usyk, a respected unified champion, he fights Daniel Dubois this weekend in Poland.
Yeah.
I wonder if I could get your thoughts on that particular fight. How do you think that fight goes?
I think it will go the same way as the Usyk Joshua fight. I think Usyk will just be too hard to hit. But
Too
I
hard.
don't think he got the power to end it early.
Okay. So, do you think Daniel could come out of it with some credit, even if he loses on points? You think he can do something where people will give him the respect?
Well, of course, and he's a hard hitter, so there's always a chance that he hits Usyk. Usyk can go down, of course.
Yeah, fair enough. Stan, looking at the heavyweight picture, do you get excited about sort of making a step into the heavyweight scene at the minute? Do you get excited about it? Do you like where the heavyweight division is?
Yeah, I think it's going the good direction at the moment because there's some exciting fights. I don't know about the Fury Ngannou fight, but well, I understand it because he wants to stay active. It's very hard for him to stay active. So in that way, I understand. Well, the Joshua fight last time, I wasn't really impressed, but I'm curious what his next step will be.
Do you think he should fight Wilder next? Do you think that's a good idea?
I think Wilder will hit him too hard.
Okay. So you think it might be a bit of, well, a day, it's a very dangerous fight.
Yeah, definitely. 100%. Every fight with Wilder is a dangerous fight.
I actually think that Joshua, well, I'm sure he did in the past do some training over at the GB team. You never know, you might bump into him over
Yeah,
there.
because that's they told me that every time because he still is there quite often.
If he's there, will you ask him to spar?
100%, of course.
Yeah. That's the thing. I don't know if you've ever met a boxer called Emmanuel Odiasi. He's
Yeah,
like,
I fought him. I fought him.
ah, how did you get on? How did the fight go?
I lost on points, but it was a good fight.
Yeah. He's a good fighter. He's a friend of ours as well, and he was over in England at the Collyer St Mostyn boxing gym. I think he sparred Wilder. He sparred Usyk. He sparred
Dillian White is sparring.
Dillian White. He
And
sparred
he's now sparring Usyk, I believe.
Yeah, exactly. So it was an interesting conversation to have with him. He's a sort of similar age as you, and again, it's one of those where you're already looking at people who maybe down the line as a professional you may end up fighting. Is that an interesting thing for you to look at? Do you keep an eye out on people in the amateurs?
Yeah, 100%. And I always love a rematch, of course, because also in our fight, I think I just had it not, I didn't have enough rounds. You know, I kept the pace up high, but eventually it's only three rounds. Amateur boxing is different from the pros, and I think at the pros I maybe have even a better chance.
Yeah, well, you're all young, aren't you, still? So there's a lot of development to go still.
Yes, 100%.
So the next step for you then, you're over here, you're going to be doing some training, and then the goal is to qualify for the Olympics, which will be a big Olympic tournament in France, Paris.
Yes, yeah, I think you are the ring announcer, right?
I'm putting my name in the hat for it. So I did the Commonwealth, so I'm going to be putting my name in the hat for it, and you never know what can happen.
Yeah, it would be great.
it would be amazing. It would be amazing. Is it hard? What's the qualifying process like for the Olympics?
It's a little bit different now because, of course, with the IBA, there's a lot of tension with all the national federations. So I believe this time was also like a little bit different qualifying process than the years before. For the European, we just had on the European Games at the end of June, the start of July, at which Delicious qualified. And now there will be two world qualifiers in February and March. So.
So at the end of March, we will know if you've qualified.
Yes.
Brilliant. Okay. Well, it's not too long ago. Is the preparations going well for everything?
Yeah, 100%. We try to get a lot of camps and a lot of fights in between because just grab the experience now. Now we can. And then we need to be there.
Well, hopefully it's good news for you and it goes smoothly. And hopefully I'll see you next week as well. I will actually ask a few people and see if about getting you in on the fight, see if that's a possibility. But I'm sure promoters like Ben Shalom would like to meet you anyway. I'm sure they would. I
Oh, perfect. Perfect.
mean, you're a heavyweight. You've sparred with Fury Allen. I'm sure that promoters would want to meet you because everybody loves a heavyweight. So maybe that's an option. We'll see. We'll see if.
Yeah, well, and of course, a part of if I'm going to qualify or not, I need to look at promoters now anyway. So that would be a great option. Yeah.
Is there any particular promoter that you like the look of, or are you keeping your op options open, or?
No, options are always open, of course.
That is the right answer. You don't want to annoy anybody just yet. Yeah.
To be a little bit smart about it.
Exactly. Well, look, it's great talking to you. I hope I see you next week. I'll stay in touch with you, and great. Give everybody your social media so they can follow you.
Well, my Instagram is just my Stan Bertens, my name, and I maybe you can put it in the description below because of the pronunciation.
Yes, I will. Everybody who wants to follow Stan in the bio below this video, in the description, I will put his Instagram link for you, everybody to look at it.
Perfect. Thank you.
Stan, great speaking to you.
Yeah,
Stay
same.
fly over here and we'll catch up hopefully very soon.
Yeah, see you soon.
Take care, bro. Appreciate
Take
it.
care.